Good evening, this is Brass Tacks, I'm Zaka Jacob. So the suspense is finally over for lakhs of CBSE students. The central government today revealed the formula by which class 12 students will be assessed going into college admissions. So it's going to be 30% weightage for class 10 exam results, 30% weightage for class 11, and 40% for class 12, you know, prelims, unit tests, practicals, etc. Is this the most equitable formula that they could have arrived at? Yes, no formula is going to satisfy everybody. But at the same time, is this the best that they could come up with? We'll get a first-hand assessment from students, teachers, parents through the course of the show. But first, the story.
More than a month and a half after the CBSE cancelled class 12th exams amid the pandemic, the Supreme Court has given a go-ahead to the board's evaluation policy. Under the new scheme, students will be assessed based on the combined performance of class 10, 11 and 12, and the results will be declared by the 31st of July.
The result committee has been given the permission or the power by the CBSE to moderate the marks based on the performance of the student throughout the year and looking into the performance of the students of the same school in past 3 years.
According to the formula, 30% marks will be computed from class 10th board exam results based on the best of three subjects. As for class 11, the average of unit, term and final exams will hold an overall weightage of 30%. And finally, 40% weightage will be given to the term exams and practicals in class 12th. In case students are not happy with the marks given by the board, they will get a chance to appear for a written exam at a later stage. To streamline the process, it is a must for schools to have a result committee that will be responsible for calculation, uploading, and other result-related matters. The Supreme Court has also directed the board to add a dispute resolution mechanism in the scheme so that grievances of students can be taken care of.
The decision is not fair for all the students because in 10th we have different subjects and in 11th, 12th we have different. So marking on the basis of other subjects for other subjects is not fair.
10th में जिस बच्चे का नंबर कम होगा तो सर उस बच्चे का भी तो हमें सोचना पड़ेगा क्योंकि सर हम प्री बोर्ड को इतने सीरियसली नहीं लेते. प्री बोर्ड को सर हम हल्के में लेते तो हमें उस तरह से हमने तैयारी नहीं किया होता सर.
10th और 12th में प्रेशर रहता है बच्चों को परसेंटेज का तो फिर 10th एंड 12th में वो ज्यादा फोकस करते हैं तो 10th 11th का बहुत ज्यादा ले लिया उन्होंने. 10th का अगर लेंगे ज्यादा और 12th का ज्यादा लेंगे तो ज्यादा ठीक रहेगा.
While on the one hand it ends the uncertainty and paves way for students to pursue their further studies, not everyone is happy with the evaluation policy. Lots of parents and students have questioned the 30% weightage to class 11th marks, since it's internal to the school and lacks a standard criteria. Moreover, many students start preparing for medical and engineering entrance exams in class 11th and take internal exams lightly.
11th standard is one of the like most unserious academic years.
Satisfied नहीं है, इसलिए नहीं है कि हमने पूरे साल बच्चों को ऑनलाइन पढ़ाया, डिपार्टमेंट ने ऑनलाइन पढ़ाया और बच्चों ने बड़ा मेहनत करी थी और बहुत बच्चों में जज्बा था कि वो इससे अच्छे रिजल्ट देते.
इस तरीके से जो सही रिजल्ट नहीं आ पाएगा. बहुत से बच्चे जो ज्यादा मेहनत करते हैं पढ़ते हैं उनके इतने नंबर नहीं आ पाएंगे.
11th में बच्चे जो है लीनियंट हो जाते हैं कि हमें तो भैया एक साल रिलैक्सेशन का मिला है तो आराम से पेपर करते हैं, बच्चे ज्यादा अच्छे नंबर नहीं ले पाते.
With the government and the Supreme Court being on the same page, the focus now shifts to the schools, who have a mountain to climb with the task of evaluating almost 14 lakh students within just 14 days. With Rishi Sinha, Anisya Kumar for CNN News 18.
All right, so let's open this up to our panel of school principals and students. I'm joined by Mrs. Kavita Das. She's the principal of the St. John's High School in Chandigarh. Mrs. Amita Mohan is the principal of the Amity International School in Pushvihar in Delhi. Shivam Seth is a class 12 student in the Modern School in Barakamba Road in Delhi. Tejaswini Sudhir is a student of class 12 affiliated with the Telangana State Board in Hyderabad. And I'm also joined by Abhishek Chaube, who's a class 12 student with the ISC board at the St. James School in Kolkata. Thank you very much, everyone, for speaking with us. I'll start with Ms. Kavita Das, first of all. Is this the most equitable formula that the CBSE could have come up with? Admittedly, I said this at the top of the show as well. You know, no one formula is going to be acceptable to everyone. So everyone will have, or someone or the other will have, something to complain about. But is this the best formula that they could have come up with? 30% for class 10, 30% for class 11, and 40% for class 12.
Well, Zaka, as you rightly said, no one's going to be fat. You can't satisfy everybody, right? But if you look at the logic that the CBSE has employed when actually formulating this policy, I think you find that there's a lot of common sense behind it. First and foremost, they have said is that the class 12, the reason they haven't given so much weightage to it is because it was an online year. Now, as we know, online results very often don't reflect the truth, right? Many children have faced connectivity issues in the rural areas. They don't even have connectivity. So it's a great difficulty. Even one exam has been taken. So where is the wages that they're going to get? Here, at least the kids in the metropolitan cities are getting choices of, you know, which exam can I choose? But those kids don't get it. So for that reason, they have decided that they wanted to use two exams, which were, one is the class 11 was offline. So it is, you know, a better reflection of the children's abilities. And the class 10, they've given the best of three. So the best of three means that the child gets the advantage over there. Having said this, you have a look at the fact that objectivity has to be the biggest criteria when deciding these kind of results. And with class 12 being online largely, and with so much variation happening across the country, it would not be fair for them to take exclusively class 12 and drop the other 2 years. I mean, the golden mean, the class 10 was an objective exam done by the CBSE, right?
Yes.
So you have over here an objectivity brought in. The class 11 is offline, so again a degree of objectivity brought in and fairness brought in. And class 12 has been given. What the kids are forgetting is, one is that there is moderation, which is going to happen. And second, they also have the weightage of their practical exams coming in. So it's not that class 12 has been ignored. It's got its weightage.
Okay, let me ask Shivam Seth. Shivam, first of all, were you happy when the CBSE decided, okay, we're not going to have physical exams because, you know, the situation is not conducive, the corona situation is not conducive? And if you were, are you happy with today's decision about the weightage, 30% for class 10, 30% for class 11, and 40% for class 12?
First of all, thank you for having me here. And I was slightly disappointed when they announced the cancellation because I had prepared. I'd studied day in and day out to give these board exams, and a part of me was happy because they didn't happen, but a part of me was also very sad because they got cancelled. And in the light of that, the decision which is being taken of 30-30-40, that takes care of most of the parameters that are required. But while computation, we also need to remember the fact that, you know, few of the most intelligent members of the country came together. And this is a scientific decision that was taken of 30-30-40. It is just random formula that is being conducted. So I think this is a good idea, this 30-30-40.
Okay, let me ask Mrs. Amita Mohan, because one of the recurring concerns that students had expressed to us was, in the case of most students, they tend to take class 11 a little lightly because you're sandwiched between, you know, two board exams in class 10 and class 12. So, you know, even the best and brightest students may not perform as well in class 11 as they would, or at least, you know, give their 120%, let's say, in both class 10 and class 12 because of the boards. So would that be an inherent disadvantage if 30% weightage is given to class 11 as well?
Good evening. I think if you see a smaller picture, yes, it will be at a disadvantage. But seeing the pandemic situation, I think it was very important to give due justice to the children, because CBSE balanced it. Because giving some weightage to 11th exam papers, everybody felt it. If not 30, they could have given 20, or not 20, they could have 10. Because some, practically all the students across all over the country do not take seats. But we have noticed over the past few years that some of the students who did not take 11 seriously in the first term,
started to take it in the second term and the final term. So they were not at a disadvantage. The ones who did not have to study in 11 will not also did not study in 12th also. And as CBSE, when they came up with this decision of giving us 30, 30, 40, they had a because you know, if this would not have been done, the hype would have been created for the 12 online papers that would have been conducted. To balance it, to bring it down, I think that is one thing which is very important. Yes, 11th class is not taken seriously by many, many of the students. But with the CBSE coming up, I think this is something where if some of the ones who did not take 11th seriously but had scored very well in class 10 and have done quite well in the online exams, the ones who sincerely worked for it, I think they'll be able to balance it for this.
Mm-hmm.
For class.
Okay, let me ask the two other students also who are joining us, Tejaswini and Abhishek. Tejaswini, I know your board has not come up with a formula yet, but I suspect almost all boards will, you know, come up with a version of what the CBSE has done. You know, give some weightage to class 10, some weightage to class 11, and some weightage to class 12. Are you happy with this formula, or are you one of those students who was, you know, focused so much on the board exam of class 12 that you didn't pay as much attention or work as much hard for class 11, or for that matter, even class 10?
I think what this formula has showed is that consistency through these crucial years in life is the must thing, which is most important. I am from the state board and we are assuming that it will follow CBSE. CBSE has included the class 10 marks as a base of assessment to 30%. So several students in ICC and CBSE and state boards, they're in class 10, and each and all the three boards have a different marking pattern and evaluation type. A 95% in ICSE is not the same as a 95% in CBSE, is not the same as a 95% in the state board. So for class 10, I feel there should be a rational methodology to normalize so that it is fair for everyone and it is a level playing field. Also in Telangana, we have not written any practical exams. Practical exams haven't taken place yet. We have not seen the inside of a laboratory, leave alone the exams based on practicals. So I don't know how that's going to play out. Are they going to conduct practicals later is a question. But otherwise, I think class 11, taking class 11 marks, personally, I'm quite happy with them taking class 10, 11, 12, I think is a very good criteria. Class 12, I think they should have reduced the weightage a bit because it's been a completely online year. So it may not be fair for each and every student. So I think they should reduce the percentage of class 12 marks.
Okay. Abhishek, again, some students alluded to the fact that, let's say, for example, you know, in class 10, you, of course, have all subjects, maths, you know, physics, chemistry, so on. But when you come to 11th, you take specializations. Some people choose the science stream, some people choose the humanities stream. So for somebody who, let's say, was not good in science and took humanities in 11th and 12th, he or she, you know, 30% weightage being judged by science and math in class 10, is that something that concerns you?
Definitely, sir. Firstly, thank you for having me here. The issue which has been raised is a real one, because I personally am a student who has changed my stream. I was a ICC student in class 10. So basically, I've changed my stream from science into commerce. So commerce is, again, an all-new field. And when I was a science student, I didn't know that I will be marked on this particular criteria. Yes, I had good marks, but that doesn't mean that 30% weightage will be given on my science marks. Another thing, there are a large section of students who have clearly said we don't want class 11 marks as consideration because we haven't prepared well in our class 11. This is justified. I can't ignore this fact. There are many students who have done that. So what's common between me and those students is all of us are against the concept of getting the past scores into consideration when we are thinking about the future scores. Basically, no student wants to be haunted by the darkness of the past to get the brightness of the future. And another important question that has been raised again and again is, if the foreign universities can accept the predicted scores of the student, then why do Indians, the Indian colleges, the Indian schools have to always go on the historical data? the student has given some kind of offline examination. Like I am a student in Kolkata and we had offline classes and offline pre-board, offline Viva, offline oral examinations. Everything was done offline in the month of February and March after the lockdown curbs were removed. Mm-hmm. So basically, why can't the students be judged on the basis of only 12th marks? Because 12th is the career shaping year. Yes, a few students are not okay with class 11. A few of them, like me, don't want class 10th marks. So why can't we have just class 12 marks? And that will be okay with all the students. Because all the students have prepared entire class 12 sitting at home. And they just had one important focus, that is boards, boards, boards. So if we are marked on boards, that will be justified, and that is something which no one can come and they won't.
It's an interesting point which all the students are raising. So I will list them out one by one. One is, what about people who change boards? A lot of students change boards after their 10th, either go from CBSE to ICSE or ICSE to CBSE. Some even go from CBSE to various state boards. So that's one big concern that students have. And two, about the streams, people who may have not been particularly good at science and, you know, at physics, maths and chemistry, so on, in class 10 and change stream to humanities or commerce in 11th and 12th, 30% of their weightage being decided by subjects that they were not good in. I'm not sure how that works. And the most important thing, and I think the point that Abhishek raised, yes, learning is a continuous process. No one is denying that. Even in the US and UK, you know, you go to university, you are graded by what's called GPA. And GPA is a continuous process. It's not just the result of one exam. But there, you know that it's going to be a continuous process as you enter the university. You know that at the end of a four-year undergraduate course, you will be judged for all 4 years. It's not like suddenly at the end of the fourth year, somebody wakes up and tells you, you're going to be, by the way, judged for all 4 years. And that, I think, is the problem in this formula. So, Mrs. Das, I'll come back to you, and both the principals, actually. What is happening is it's retrospective. If these students were told, and I know this is not possible because these are extraordinary circumstances, but I think if these students were told going into class 10 that, look, you'll be judged with both class 10, 11, and 12. If our learning was an emphasis on continuity and on continuum rather than the result of one exam for which we all put so much focus, then this would be an equitable system. But to now retrospectively say, oh, by the way, you'll also be judged by two other grades where you may or may not have given your 100%, I think there is a point in what the students are trying to say. Mrs. Das first.
Absolutely. There is, they have relevance in what they are saying. But as you also mentioned, these are unusual times. We have to find some sort of a solution which will look at your performance over a period of time. As the CBSE has pointed out, they've said that the class 12 results are not entirely reliable because of the fact that there's so much variation. Now, one child has had offline, one child has had online, one child has struggled to even get online. What happens? How do you reach an equitable solution there? So somewhere they had to take in an exam which was offline for everybody. And that was class 11 and class 10 again, as we've all said. Now, this thing about, you know, I have gone in for science, so I don't want my class 10. Hey, they're taking the best three and they haven't said that it has to be science or it has to be maths or it has to be this, depending on your stream. It's not linked to your stream. It's linked to the best three. So the child is getting the advantage there, isn't he? It's on his performance. The best three subjects which he's got are going to be taken into account. So if I wasn't very good at maths, that'll get left out. If I wasn't very good at social studies, that'll get left out. And the weightage will go to my best three subjects. So there is a rationale over here that is very consistent with the view of objectivity at the heart of it. And to look at the fact that this is a country which does not only exist in the cities. It also looks at the rural scenario. Sure. So you have to take into account the entire gamut of experiences across the country during this pandemic time before you can make a decision. And yes, I agree, it has been done retrospectively, but what choice did they have?
True. Mrs. Mohan, just the question about the students who change boards. A lot of students change boards after class 10. So how do you redress that concern?
Sorry, could you repeat this thing? I couldn't hear
The students who change the boards, for example, if they're in an ICSE school in class 10, some of them shift to a CBSE school in class 11 and 12. Many students who are in CBSE or ICSE in class 10 shift to state board schools in class 11 and class 12. So how do you reconcile the difference in these boards and the marks that these boards give if you're going to take a weighted average of all 3 years?
I think even if you change the board from ICSE to CBSE or vice versa or to the state board, they have told us to take the best three as it is, as Anupam Das also said it, because it is very important. Every board, whether it is ICSE or the state board, gives marks, and if you would have seen the results of the past many years when offline exams were being conducted, all the boards always had a percentages above 90. Of course, the average students or the below average ones who did not work hard onto the fact for the board exams could not score it. But if you would see that there were so many students who were faring so well in all the boards, be it ICSE or the state boards or the CBSE boards. So, but if even if the weightage is being taken for class 10, and that also for the best of the three subjects, whatever board you may have appeared, that is why CBSE took this decision, because CBSE also had it in their mind that there will be children who will shifting from one board to the other. So there's no disadvantage to a child, even if the child in the class 10th has shifted from one board to the other board. So that disadvantage
all right. I'll give the students the final word. I'll start with Shivam. On the question of different streams, you know, I may have been bad at science and I changed to humanities, but then you have the option of giving the best three subjects that you scored in class 10. So that should make it a little more equitable, a little more fair, Shivam?
Yes, certainly. Again, at this point, it gives the advantage to the students that they can choose whichever text they want. So this would certainly be advantageous. And another point that those people who are not comfortable with the class 10 and 11 marks, the board has also given that later when the conducive environment is there, you can take the board. So I don't see any reason why there should be a problem. But one point I feel where the board needs to concentrate, the class 12 exams, like the exams which have happened throughout the year. You know, I've had many friends who've got COVID, who have not been able to give the midterms, who have not been able to give the practicals. How will you mark them there?
Okay. All right, Tejaswini and Abhishek. Tejaswini, you go first, 30 seconds, and then Abhishek for the final comment.
Yeah, I think the stream, because the board is giving an option of best of three subjects, I think it makes it easy. For instance, I am a science student, so I can choose science, maths, and English as the best of three. So I think the best of three has been a very good option given by the board, so I think it's going to be fair.
All right. Abhishek, again, I come back to the moot point. World over, learning is a continuous process. Students are judged in a continuum, not so much the result of one exam. So perhaps to that extent, this is a good system?
Definitely, sir. Sir, a student cannot just be judged by the scores he or she gets in his class 10 or 12 examinations. It is the aptitude in the reality world that matters more than these marks. And at the other side, we were talking about the changing of streams. I would like to add something to this. The cancellation of board examinations was a uniform decision for all the students, be that a topper, be that an average, and be that a nominal student. So if this was a uniform decision, then why aren't the stakeholders given the actual point of, upheld? Why aren't the class 12 students being upheld in this decision? And by upheld, I mean, if they are unhappy, if a section of society, if only 0.1% of the society students are not okay with class 10th or 11th marks, then why aren't the boards coming to a final formula that if you have prepared for class 12, there shouldn't be any disparity when it comes to class 12, the practical examination, the pre-board examination, the oral examination, anything which you have done.
Okay.
So, in my opinion,
No, I also want to remind the students and the teachers as I wrap up this chat that the CBSE has also said those students who want to take the physical exam, if the situation does permit, will have the option of taking the physical exam as well, hopefully before the 31st of July when they will have to make the results public. I want to thank all our guests. Thank you so much for joining us. I've got a piece of breaking news, and this is a big one, a political one coming in from Bengal, where Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee has moved the Calcutta High Court challenging the electoral result in the constituency of Nandigram. Remember, that was the high-profile battle between Mamata Banerjee and Shivendu Adhikari, which she lost by a few thousand votes. I think it went on to the final round of counting. And finally, it was Shivendu Adhikari who prevailed in the Nandigram constituency. She is now challenging that result in the Calcutta High Court. All right, Kamalika is joining us on the phone line. Kamalika, this is a big move by the Chief Minister.
Yeah, absolutely. And this was what was expected, because after the election win of the 2nd May, she also stated that they are looking into the option to move in court. And that's what she did. And, you know, this is an election petition, which she has done, and challenging the results of Nandigram. She has moved High Court through an election petition under the People's Representation Act. And tomorrow is going to be the hearing. So very interesting battle we have seen in Nandigram. And after that, after the results, there were certain questions which were raised by Trinamool Congress Party. And that point of time itself, Mamata Banerjee stated that she is looking into the legal options. And rightly, after looking into all the legal options,
all right,
she has applied for an election petition. And tomorrow is the hearing.
Okay, we'll see how that plays out. Thanks very much, Kamalika Sengupta, for joining us with the details on that story. Big move this by the Bengal Chief Minister. As we wrap up, tomorrow, of course, is the first day of the first ever World Test Championship final. It is India versus New Zealand. Our best wishes to Virat Kohli and his team. Thanks for tuning in. We'll catch you again tomorrow night, same time.